Hello and welcome back to SoneMK for another video. Today's video is about Eve Room, a Apple HomeKit supported indoor air quality monitor that now comes with RED support. Eve Room is something that I've had for some time now, and it's great addition to health side of your smart home, as Eve Room is designed to track air quality, temperature and humidity. And as always, we'll have a deep dive on this one, and here are some topics that we'll go through in this video. And if you're not familiar with RED, stay until the end as I'll give you introduction on it as well in this video. But now, let's dig deeper on Eve Room. Let's start with design. An aluminium body surrounds the device with a matte finish and a polished chamfered edge. It's having a high contrast e-ink display. The device is small in size and, as it's also beautiful design, you can place it anywhere in your home. But as there's no backlight in e-ink display, it will impact visibility during nighttime, for example. On backside, you'll find micro USB port for charging. Now, as this is introduced at the end of 21, having a micro USB connector seems a bit odd, as you would have expected to have a USB-C, but it is there. Now, what it can do? This is an indoor air quality monitor. It measures three metrics: temperature, humidity, and air quality, or VOC, concentration. All these three are showing in the screen. You can set temperature to Celsius or Fahrenheit. Humidity is showing as percentage, and VOC, which stands for volatile organic compound, is showing a star rating in the device and particles per billion reading in the app. Now, temperature is pretty obvious, but other things like air humidity. Depending on where you live, air humidity might be something you want to monitor, as optimal air humidity is between 30-50%. And in areas where you have different seasons during the year, like winter, air humidity in winter time goes low, lower than what's good for you. It can go below 20%, for example. And in more tropical locations, air humidity is high, pretty much all the time. And if you can monitor air humidity, you can control it, at least inside your house. For example, if you're having too low air humidity, you can have humidifier to raise air humidity. Or if you're having constantly high air humidity, you can have dehumidifier. And if you can quickly hit that thumbs up button, it really helps the channel out, so thank you so much for doing that. And consider subscribing if you haven't already done so. Now, another important part what Eve Room measures is air quality. It's something called VOC, volatile organic compound. Again, this might be affected on where you live, what kind of baseline you'll have in your home in that way. But it's affected on different things that you might not be aware of, like cooking in some occasions, or if you're handling some chemicals, for example when you're cleaning, setting up fire in fireplace. These kind of events will show up in air quality monitoring. Eve Room shows air quality in screen. It will show air quality as stars. Maximum is 5 stars. Also, you'll get detailed info from Eve app, but let's see the app more closely in a minute. There are 4 different display modes, one showing all 3 data points, and the others highlighting one in particular. You can select this by pressing capacitive touch buttons from the side of the screen. Response is a bit slow. You'll need to press 1-2 seconds before anything happens. It's not changing view instantly. But let's have a quick look what was on the box before we continue. You'll find Eve Room with the USB charging cable. It's a micro USB and not USB-C. There's no power adapter, but any USB-A type of power adapter will do. And then we have paperwork. A quick guide helping you to set everything up. When setting it up, first thing you'll need to do is to put it on charger. It'll take about 2 hours to fully charge Eve Room. And while it's charging, you can download Eve app to your mobile device from App Store. It's called Eve for HomeKit. When Eve Room is fully charged, open the Eve app and you'll need to add accessory, and the setup will guide you. You'll need to scan the QR code from the backside of Eve Room. Setup also guides you to place Eve Room on the location you'll be measuring for half a day. And after that, it should be placed to some well-ventilated place for about a half an hour. I just put it outside. Purpose for this is to calibrate the sensors. After that, it can be placed back to location where you want to keep it, and it's good to go. and for battery life is said to last 6 weeks, but it seems to last even longer. And by using an e-ink display, Eve can keep the battery draw to a minimum. Now, let's have a look on the app. Eve app is showing your device and what measurements it's collecting. It takes the temperature and humidity readings every 10 minutes when looking at the measurement entries. As with the air quality readings, you can look at the historical data in hour, day, week and month view, which is useful. Within the Eve app, you can also use the humidity and temperature sensors to trigger other HomeKit devices. So, for example, you could set your fan to turn on if the temperature rises, or set dehumidifier if the humidity is too much, and so on. Eve app is showing air quality in more detail than what's showing in the display. It's giving you specific air quality information based on parts per billion. You can again see air quality at a glance within the app, but also see historical data in an hour, day, week and month view. As with other data points, you can also export the data. Now, as mentioned before, Eve Room supports Apple HomeKit. HomeKit integration allows users to review the status of the home at any time via the Home app, Eve for HomeKit app, or through Siri.
Humidity in the bedroom is normal, at 35%.
Measurements provided by the Eve Room can also be used in automation with other HomeKit-enabled accessories, such as turning on humidifier in wintertime when air humidity gets too low, or air dehumidifier if it's too much in summertime, or turning on air purifier when air quality declines, or turning on aircon or fan if temperature rises to certain point. There's so many automations you can create when you have other smart devices in your house. iPhone's Home app doesn't show historical data even though HomeKit still collects this information. To view historical data collected from the Eve Room's sensors, you need to see it from the Eve app. Now, there's something new with this third generation Eve Room. It now supports Thread, and let's talk about that now. Thread is a new protocol that creates a fast mesh network community among supported devices, and it does so by using low energy and communication between Thread devices is faster. The Thread network is self-healing, so the entire community will reroute and maintain your remaining devices related if one device goes offline. To take full benefit of Thread, you need what's referred to as Thread Border Router. Such devices are the latest generation Apple TV 4K or HomePod Mini. These kind of devices are also called as full Thread devices. In Thread network, Eve Room is an endpoint device, also called as minimal Thread device, which means it's not going to augment your existing Thread network, but it becomes part of it and will send data reliably with low power consumption. And if you don't have other Thread devices yet, Eve Room will work with Bluetooth as well. There are big industry-leading companies committed to Thread devices, like Apple, Amazon, Google, and so on. And Eve is part of this group. And Eve CEO is saying that soon Thread network will be just as common in your houses as Wi-Fi is these days. As conclusion, Eve Room does well what it's set to do, to monitor temperature, air humidity and air quality. It isn't that cheap as this costs 99 euros or $99, and depending on the size of your house, you might need to invest 2 or 3 of these. And you'll find cheaper options from the market to monitor these metrics, but software and the integration to your smart home is what stands out here. Naturally, the Eve Room can't do anything about VOC it has detected in your home, but it can let you know when to open a window or turn on air purifier. Plus, it's definitely useful paired with other HomeKit accessories like smart plug connected to an air purifier or some other device. And if you made it this far, I hope today's video was useful. Please drop a like and let me know in the comments if you have questions, experiences, or if you're planning to have one. I'll try to answer all. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great day and we'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.